Some stuff can be more easily achieved with virtual machines as compared to physical ones. A good example is file transfer. So let's say that we have two computers, a Windows 11 one and an Ubuntu one. Now let's say that we want to transfer some files from one to the other. So how can we do that? We can copy the files to a USB flash drive, then physically take it to the other computer. Another option, if both of the computers are on the same network, is something like SFTP or SCP. Now, let's say that the Ubuntu machine is actually a virtual machine within the Windows 11 one. All of the options I just mentioned are still at our disposal, but we have an additional one, which is arguably the most convenient of them all. And this is shared folders. Notice that shared folders will only work if you have the guest editions installed on your guest. We talked about the guest editions installation in one of the previous parts, so I'm going to assume that it's already done. First, let's create the shared folder on our host. Great. Let's now create a text file in this folder, and this is going to be the file that we want to be able to access to in the guest. Great. Now, back in the virtual machine, we need to add a user to the vboxsf group. The simplest way to do it is probably add user, so that's what I'm going to do. And this will take care of permissions to the shared folder in the guests side. We now need to turn off the virtual machine and tell VirtualBox which folder we want to share. First, make sure that the correct virtual machine is selected from the list. We now need to scroll down a bit in the settings of this machine. And here we have it, shared folders. We want to add a new shared folder to this virtual machine, so let's click on the Add icon. We need to specify the folder's path. This is the path on the host, so in my case, it's the new folder I just created on the desktop. We can change its name, but I think that using the name of the folder itself makes a lot of sense, so I'll just leave it as it is. And let's check the auto mount box, so we won't have to manually mount the shared folder ourselves. As for the mount point, you can go with every path you want, but by default, the Linux file system places external storage in the media folder. So even though you don't have to, it makes a lot of sense to specify a path inside it. Okay, we're done. Let's start the virtual machine and see how things look from the guest's side. And let's take a look at our file system. And right away, we can see a new external storage device. And its path is the path we specified. And here's the file we created in our host. By the way, you can list all of the shared folders from the guest itself using the command vboxcontrol shared folder. And we can see our shared folder with all of its properties. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.